And today we have for you the executive director of the Advanced Consortium on Cooperation and a Columbia University professor on psychology and education who has a new book coming out that's titled The Way Out: How to Overcome Toxic Polarization. Welcome in, Peter Coleman.
Thank you so much for having me.
Now, Peter, this is huge because right now there seems to be so much division in our society. What is The Way Out about?
So you're right, we are at record high levels, according to some estimates, of political polarization in Washington and on Main Street. And it's part of a long 50-year pattern. So what I try to do in the book is quickly explain how we got so stuck for so long, and then talk about the science. I study societies like ours that have been stuck in patterns like this. And I try to share with the reader that what the science tells us about the conditions that help us change and change course.
And it's so important that we change course because, hey, we were in the Trump administration for 4 years. Now we have the Biden administration. It is day and night, but it seems like there are a lot of really kind of ongoing issues that continue to permeate. So I guess without giving away too much, what is it that The Way Out kind of provides in terms of guidance?
Well, the reason I wrote the book is because it's something that I've studied for decades. I've studied these societies that are able to come out of really even civil wars, but highly contentious periods or phases. And so what we're trying to do is offer specifically what people can do and bring that down to your life, your world. So one of the premises of our book and of our research is that because when we are so polarized, things start to seem very simple. It seems like they're insane. We're victims of their insanity. It's simple. There are clear truths here. And what starts to happen again is that we oversimplify so much, the issues, the other, and even our sense of ourselves. So what one of the premises of the book is that we need to complicate our lives, that we need to start to listen to some folks who we disagree with politically. Not everybody, not the extremes, but you need to find people in your life that you feel are, you know, smart and reasonable, even though you disagree, and stay in conversation with them so that you begin to challenge some of your basic assumptions and habits. Because we are not only, you know, emotionally moving apart and feeling a sense of contempt for the other, which can of course lead to incidents like January 6th, but we're physically moving away from each other within cities, into different neighborhoods, rural, urban splits, and virtually on the internet, we're sort of being sorted into different tribes. So we are losing contact with the other side, and that is a recipe for violence. So my recommendation is that you think about how can you complicate your life, travel to places where you meet different kinds of people, watch news, go to internet sources that perhaps will challenge you, even though you don't need to go to everything that's out there, but go to some things that challenge your basic thinking. Complicate your life is the message.
Yes, and it sounds like it's something that a lot of people could use. And some of the things you just said really kind of made me think in terms of who is the target audience here, because we know January 6th, primarily it was white people, conservatives, and also the reality when you say that people are going and living in more segregated lives. Generally, it's been white people who live in constantly segregated lives. So is that kind of the aim for this book in terms of who it's directed toward and who could use this the most?
Yeah, so one of the things, again, we've learned from studying these societies that change is that one condition you need is that you need enough moderates in the middle that are fed up with the nonsense and the vitriol and the hate and entertainmentization of the news. And fortunately, we are. There's a group called More in Common that studies the US, and they estimate something like 86% of middle moderate Americans are just fed up with the craziness of Washington and the media and the internet and want to engage politically in a different way and kind of gain, you know, take back our democracy. That's who the book is written for. It's for those people that are fed up and looking for other ways to move us forward.
And I understand that you're a renowned expert when it comes to constructive conflict resolution and sustainable peace. And so I was wondering, What, I know you talked about really what encouraged you to write this book, but I guess what part of your expertise did you feel like was lacking when you looked every day in all of these issues that seem to be coming up in our society?
Well, so if you look at how people talk about political polarization, they oftentimes say, well, it's because, you know, red Americans, blue Americans have different moral values, or because they have, you know, different levels of sensitivity of threat in their brains, or because of gerrymandering, or because of the internet or news, or, you know, there's always the answer as to why we're so divided. What I find is that's not accurate, that all of those things matter, but what matters more is how they start to kind of feed each other in complicated ways and create these patterns, these like riptides in our community that pull us apart and split us apart. In other words, the polarization in our culture today is bigger than any one of us. So it's not something that you and I can just simply sit down and talk about. We need to think about it in a different way, and we need to find groups and individuals in our communities that can help us have those conversations, because they're very difficult conversations and they take a lot of time, and ideally they take facilitation between people that know how to do that.
And so when you talk about, you know, these polarizing mindsets and the things that are changing how we interact with one another, how much of a role does the push for the power structures and reinforcing those? And by the main power structures, I mean gender, race, class. How much does that play a role?
It plays a major role. I mean, one of the major structures that plays, I think, a considerable role is capitalism and the business model of entertainmentization of media and trying to gain our attention through taking very complex issues and saying, here's two sides to this issue, let's get the most extreme voices and have them at each other. And we think that's conversation, and we think that's a way to teach Americans about these issues, and it does the opposite, it just moves us apart. So the business model behind a lot of news media, behind a lot of social media are part of the problem. But you're absolutely right. There are antagonists that weaponize white supremacy and race. They weaponize gender dynamics and gender discrimination. They know how to play into crowds in order to divide them. And they do that very effectively. So those factors, which are part of the American context, make us ripe for division, make us ripe to be pulled apart.
Yeah, I absolutely agree with you. And watching it really be exploited, it's been difficult to watch, especially when people are relinquishing themselves of actual facts and playing into fear and fear mongering. And so if people are looking for essentially the way out, what is maybe a tip you can give them in terms of the benefit that your book will provide to their personal lives?
So the book ends up in a set of what I call new rules. So that if you find yourself wanting to have a conversation with, you know, your brother-in-law or someone that you work with who you know you have strong political differences with, it gives you some ideas, some nudges that you can do to try to engage in that way. And so one of them is, I encourage you to move. I encourage you not to sit down at a table across from each other and try to have a conversation. I encourage you to say, let's go for a walk. Let's go for a walk outside. Because one of the things neuroscience has taught us is that when people are outside physically moving, you know, side by side, moving together, they tend to synchronize together, their neurons start to synchronize, and they start to feel more compassionate and understanding and flexible and cooperative. And so even physical movement can help you get to a place where you can start to have conversations over difficult issues in which you disagree without them getting out of control. So that's just one insight from the book that I would recommend.
Yes, and that is a very powerful one, especially with us coming out of this pandemic, where many of us were locked up inside. I'm sure it did not help for when it came to conflict resolution at all. Now, I know you're probably very excited to get your book out there. And so just for anyone who's really looking to dive in, what resource other than The Way Out would you provide them? Is there any kind of maybe a precursor that they should prep themselves on, or is The Way Out the great starting point and you can just go from there?
Yeah, so there is a website for the book. Actually, the book just came out, so it is out. There it is. And there is a website for the book. It's thewayoutofpolarization.com. And that gives you a little context to why I wrote the book. And there's exercises and ideas and a lot of media in there. So that's a good way to get a taste of the book. But I try to write this book for human beings that are feeling sick and tired of this situation, feeling trapped, and really want to have some ideas about how to move out of that. So it's written for everybody.
That is awesome. And that is something we very, very much need right now, as there is so much division right now, and trying to find a way to get a way out is so incredibly important. So thank you so much for joining us, Peter. And anyone who's out there, please check out The Way Out, How to Overcome Toxic Polarization. I'm guessing it's available everywhere books can buy. Is that correct?
It is, you're right.
Yes, wonderful. So head over to your local virtual bookstore and pick up a copy. Thanks so much for joining us, Peter.
Thank you for having me.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.